Every thought is received by the brain, which is an organ of the conscious mind. If it is accepted as true, then it is sent to the subconscious mind like a seed and deposited. The more and more you continue to think a thought or a line of thinking, that thought or seed is nurtured and watered and takes root in your subconscious. This is the law of sowing and reaping, if you will. Just like the law of gravity is impartial and impersonal and has the same effect on everyone and everything, so does the law of sowing and reaping. You sow a thought, think a thought, you water it by your attention to it, then it will take root and produce fruit, good or bad, depending on the nature of the thought. So what do we do about negative thoughts and beliefs that have taken root in our subconscious then? Well, first you must be aware of their existence and be able to identify them. That's pretty easy. Any negative thought makes you feel bad, worrisome, irritable, etc. So right there off the bat, you can just identify a negative thought by how it makes you feel. Now that sounds really simple, but it is really simple. So we have these thoughts that we've been thinking for a long time. They're pretty deeply rooted, so we just can't yank them up, these thought patterns and belief patterns, because they're ingrained. So what do? You starve them, literally starve them, by refusing to give them your attention. And eventually, completely replace them with positive thoughts. So you see, negative thinking is a habit in itself. The easiest way out of negative thinking is so simple that you're gonna have to have someone help you to misunderstand what I'm about to say. Are you ready? You simply don't fight it. You don't argue with it. You don't get in that thought and think, how am I gonna figure this out? This person said this to me. I'm gonna tell them this. I'm gonna do that. And you get in this huge cycle and it just goes over and over again in your mind. Don't try and reason it out. Three simple words. Let it go. Instead, think about anything that makes you feel better. I don't care if it's the new Starbucks coffee that just came out. Think about that. Think about your kids and, you know, something sweet that they might say to you or they've done in the past. Whatever it takes. Just go positive. I remember I told you it was so simple, it almost seems too good to be true, but do it. And do it over and over and over again until you're free of that negative thought pattern that has such a hold. Okay? Now, I've had to do this just today, and it has helped a lot. And I can tell you, a year ago, I wouldn't have been able to do this as well. I won't go into the details, but believe me, instead of fighting to be right, trying to have it all figured out, feeling like I'm in control and I know what's going on, it is really best to just let it go and find a way to feel better. Go for a walk. Think about your favorite thing. Whatever it takes. The goal is to get to a better feeling state so you can have better thoughts and therefore have better feelings and better thoughts, feed better feelings, and back and forth. And you are on a positive track instead of a negative track. So I hope this helped you today. I know it's a little bit long, but good luck with that. And again, always do your meditations in the morning and the evening. Do them throughout the day. A really good time to take advantage of any kind of meditation is when you are driving, as long as you're paying attention to the road. So keep that in mind. I'll send out something tomorrow. Stay tuned.